stars fall at my feet. Keep me grounded as I reach higher than I see. Is there something there for me? Pulling back the reins, letting go again. I'm not afraid. I'm not.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is 8 o'clock p.m., kind of. It's Sunday night. What does that mean? It's touring car night. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome along to the final round of the season here at Brands Hatch, just outside Kent, in England. And we're here for the final round of the season for the Touring Car Championships. My name's Kelly Davis, and I am in the booth with my very good friend, who I've known now for, it must be 4 or 5 months. Matthew Duffin, how are you?
Good evening, Kelly. Very well. Thank you. Yourself?
Yeah, top of the world, mate. Top of the world.
Top of the world. 4 or 5 months. Feels like 4 or 5 years.
It does, doesn't it? We feel like old friends, don't we?
Yeah.
You know, absolutely. to the point where we've got just the best banter, haven't we?
Back and forth
over how incredibly poor Hondas really are. There will be plenty of Honda digs this evening because we've just come off the back of the first round of the actual British Touring Car Championships.
Yes.
And touring cars is what we like, isn't it, Matthew?
Touring cars is what we know best. It's what we do best. It's what we like best. It's just the best. That's why we're here tonight on this Sunday evening to bring you the final of this touring cars round. And you say that Honda are not very good. Honda won the first two races of the touring cars this season, so, you know, it's not the Honda team, but, you know, it's still a Honda.
And second place in the Grand Prix. So,
I know.
But, you know, I've said it before, they make a great lawnmower.
So. Hey, and Shedden proved that earlier in race one when he decided to plough into the back of Jackson and spear into the side of Smiley and then thought, oh, I'll cut your grass while I'm heading towards this wall.
Absolutely.
But yes, we've got a cracking night of racing ahead of us, haven't we, Kelly?
We have as well. Yes, you're right. It's the championship decider, last two races of this current season for the touring cars. And there's some changes to the next season, which we'll have a chat about a bit later on. But for now, we've got three guys in this one. John Boy, the man you're watching right now, championship contender. And as is Laney, wherever, let me find Laney. Laney is your other championship contender this evening. And with an outside chance of this one, still mathematically possible, is Dolore. So those are the guys you've got to keep pay attention to for the championship this evening. There'll be other guys that will be very, very quick around here, as there always is. But those are the three guys who are in the hunt for this evening. What are your kind of thoughts on that one, Matt? Who do you think's going to be strong?
It's going to be hard to look past Laney, I reckon. But John Boy, a previous winner 2 seasons ago here at Motives Touring Cars in the Tier 1s. So he's got the experience of getting over the line and getting the championship done. A 9-point gap between the two. I'm going to swing towards Laney, though, tonight. We've seen the pace of the young man who's he's got a few Prolapse teammates on the track to help him out tonight, and I'm sure we'll have the backing and support of the Prolapse guys in the chat throughout the evening as well. Dolore, like you said, an outside shot. It would be nice to see him maybe come through the field and have a good night tonight. Maybe try and make it a bit interesting as we go into the feature race, especially. But it's going to be a tricky one for him to get done and get across the line. But I'm looking forward to this one. It's going to be three guys all for the title. And as we see in the real world, Kelly, when you can get to the final few races of the season and you turn up to the final event and you've got three or four guys who's up for the title, this is what the touring cars is about. And this is why we thrive on it, because it's so fun to watch.
Absolutely. It's so competitive and so grassroots racing is touring car. It's, you know, it's such pure racing. Because the field is so close. This is traditionally the last meeting of the season for the actual British Touring Car in real life is normally here at Brands GP as well. So in the spirit of British Touring Car, which this whole season has been about this year, we are at the last round of the season, as I said. And yes, I think Laney is going to... I'm going to back John Boy for this one, but I don't know if I can contractually, because I'm a Prolapse driver, aren't I? So, I think John Boy's got a good shout at it, but you're quite right. Laney is also going to have the support of his two fellow Prolapse drivers, which are in there. Now, I've spoke to Dan about it. We've chatted to Dan about it, and Dan is going to run his own race. He's not going to get in the way of a championship battle, but he's not going to hinder one either. So Dan's being the gentleman driver that he normally is, and he's going to just stay out of the way of the battle. If they come up behind him and they're quick, either one of them, he's going to let them go and not fight them too hard, is Daniel's stance on it. We'll see how true that will be if he's fighting for a win, yeah. Of course. And the other one is X-Mart. Now, if you go back to last year, and people who follow Motive Touring Car go back to last year, our reigning champion, X-Mart, is also a prolapse driver and very, very good friends and work colleagues with Laney. And Laney definitely played the rear gunner to X-Mart's championship at the tail end of last year. Is he going to get the same respect from X-Mart? Again, spoke to him just recently, we both did, and he's looking after his teammate and his friend. So,
and this is the interesting thing to go. He had the help and support of Laney last season. Is he looking to return that favour this year to keep Prolapse as the number one team in the Tier 1 Tour of Cars? I know, obviously, there's no teams championship, but are they looking to be that force of bringing the drivers into touring cars and helping them win the championships that they have longed for all season long and battled out for? And we've seen at times this season, Kelly, where the McGanns haven't had it their own way, especially in that wet conditions with the two BMWs on grid, the only other two cars on the grid in Dan and Gary 131. We've seen at times that the BMWs have been the pick, yep, of the cars throughout this season, especially in the wet weather. Which we're led to believe we have a wet qualifying for the feature race. So we'll see, yes, how the BMWs indeed get on compared to the dry races. But Laney has held his own. He's been consistent throughout the season. I'm just looking at his results in front of me. Now, you know, lowest finish of a 11th place in the sprint race at Snetterton. But bar that, a lot of podiums. Three fourths. A 6th and an 11th, everything else has been on the podium. So just 5 races off the podium in what has been such a cracking season for Laney. Looking at John Boy as well, again, he's just been a bit more inconsistent in terms of he's had more races off the podium. Only a lowest finish of 8th, but when he's not been on the podium, it's been more frequent than what Laney has. So John Boy, we've worked to do, and as you can see at the minute, John Boy's setting the pace 5 thousandths quicker than Lodder in this short practice session before we get the, yeah, reverse grid underway. Laney not showing his pace at the moment, and as for Delore, only 0.2 off the back of John Boy. It's going to be a fascinating night, and in typical touring car fashion, as John Boy just improves by 0.1 here, we're seeing a second between the top 8, in which we've not got Gary on that list. There's no Gary there.
No. I was going to point out that we have got a couple missing. Gary is missing in the other BMW. I can't see Andy either. No Andy this evening by the looks of it.
Well, Gary was there a moment ago because I did see his name.
Oh, was he?
But,
okay.
I
don't know what's happened to Gary for whatever reason, but we don't be seeing him right now. He has got an opportunity to get in this practice session. So let's hope that he turns out. I say, I don't see Andy either, which is a shame, because Andy is another quick guy and was contender last year for the championship.
Obviously, go back to the beginning of the season, Andy was one that was saying, I've got to get more podiums, be more consistent.
Yeah.
I want the championship this year. Obviously, it's not worked out for him. Whatever reason. I was just about to say, could we just talk about Gary's run recently? The recent form of Gary 131 has been 5 podiums in the last 6 races. I mean, that's fantastic form for the BMW driver. To put him 5th in the championship at the moment on a season which the BMWs have struggled quite a lot. We've seen Dan and Gary really struggle. So that form in this back half of the season has been fantastic.
Well, let's talk about that. Are those podiums been by any chance in the wet conditions for those good results for Gary and for Dan? I think have they not been in wet conditions for that BMW?
I'm not 100%. I can't remember going back to all the races, but 5 of the last 6. I don't remember 5 of the last 6 being wet.
No.
In that space of time, Dan only took 2 podiums in the last 6 races. So,
Where I'm going with this is I'm going to reveal, and it's been revealed just earlier in with the Tier 2s going on. Now, the problem with the Touring Car Series on Project Cars is that the Renault Megane is dominant, and particularly dominant over all the other touring cars. The BMW is a little bit better in the wet than the Megane, but other than that, the Megane is pretty much the class of the field. So, big news for next season on Motive, the Renault Megane is being banned for next season.
Yeah, so, interesting news.
Yes. All these guys who are now running these Renault Meganes, and we have... There's only two BMWs in the field, and no Astras and no Mercedes, which are the other two options on project cars, although the Astra is DLC. But the other two options aren't used at all. And we've only got two BMWs who do have been in the hands, of two quick drivers. Let's face it, Gary and Dan are both very, very quick drivers. So, and you know, they've had to wring the neck of that BMW, to make it competitive. So it's going to open up for next season, that's for certain sure. So the big news, Renault Megane will be banned for next season.
It will be. As Delore ended that session quickest from John Boy by 0.02 seconds. With Laney not really showing his pace, and I've just spoke with Gary on the Facebook Messenger. He was kicked from the session. He's trying to get back in. So hopefully Gary can get back in for the race. Like I say, five podiums in the last six races. Brilliant form. And with Andy, as Emo Guy says in the chat, that Gary can take fourth place in this championship come the end of the night. So, you know, a testament to the form he's been in at this back half of the season. But obviously the main focus tonight, Laney, John Boy, Delore, all for this title fight that is happening throughout. There's obviously other battles for places here and there throughout the championship that will happen tonight, but the main focus on the front three. So we're going to do the reverse grid. Kelly, do you want me to just take you through the grid order?
Yes, please, if you could, just for those who haven't, who've never joined us before, the first race, the sprint race, runs under a reverse grid, so it's a championship order. The guys go off on a formation lap, and we'll get into that order, and we'll have a rolling start, and Matthew Duffin will give you that grid order.
Thank you very much. So it's in reverse championship order, so the Greek will start on pole, obviously, with being the bottom of the championship, and so on and so forth. So the Greek will start on pole. Poknik will start in P2. Vlieger will start in third place on the second row, alongside Lodder in P4. Row 3 will be Nick the Villa and Emo Guy. Row 4, WSRCJ and Fury. Row 5, Dan, a.k.a. on Orthodox, and Xmark. Row 6 was meant to be Gary and Delore, but Gary kicked and hasn't got back in. I can't see his name on them standing, so hasn't been able to get back in, so he'll obviously be there for the feature race. So this will then bump Delore up to P11, John Boy will be bumped up to P12, and Laney will be bumped up to P13. With obviously only 13 drivers on the grid. So that's the Greek first, Poknik second, Vliegerk third, Lodder fourth, Nick the Villa fifth, Emo Guy sixth, WSRCJ seventh, Fury eighth, Unorthodox ninth, Xmark tenth, Delore 11th, John Boy 12th, Laney 13th.
Yes, indeed. So only 6 points, as I believe, separates Laney and John Boy from the win. Delore is still possible mathematically, but I think is unlikely. So the real fight is between John Boy and Laney, and as I said, it's reverse grid, so they start from the back of the grid, and we'll see how they get on in this thing. So we are, looks like we're syncing up. As I said, it's a rolling start. These guys have done this week in, week out, so you'll probably find that they all find their positions reasonably quickly. The lights go on, there you go, and they start to roll away from the grid, and as I said, you'll see the slower guys come to the forward, and the likes of Laney is already at the back, so he doesn't have to go far, does he?
He doesn't
have to go far at all. Very quickly in chat, Iron Brew Racing, good evening all. Thoughts on British Touring Car today? Well, what can we say? No doubt we'll get into it and we'll reference it, but Touring Car's back.
Yeah.
You know, that's the big news. Compared to the Grand Prix, it was, awesome.
Yeah, same as what you say there, Kelly. Buzzing this morning, and then just the racing, just such good, close, competitive, brilliant British touring car racing with drama everywhere. We spoke off air about the Andy Neat incident. We spoke, a bit about Sheridan. We had a bit of a joke about Sheridan and Turkington. But all in all, that third race especially, with it being wet, and they all start on a wet tyre, and then it went dry and Jake Hill was flying, and then it really had a downpour and Sutton come back. That is the touring cars, and that for
good
me is
racing.
Brilliant. Yeah. Also, evening to Evil Scotsman, a.k.a. Emo Guy, on the track. The only G says, good luck all. Fury's Grandad, evening Kelly and Matt, good luck to all. Go Fury
evening,
and the wall,
Tony.
The wall. Plenty of time for the wall. It's touring cars time.
Yeah.
Yes, guys, as we've got a spinner mid-pack. We've had a spinner mid-pack. I do believe it's... I actually don't know. Is it It's not Fiori. It's the red car there that's just returning to track. That's just past them.
Nick Villa.
Nick Villa then has had a bit of a Nick spin Villa. Coming down. I tell you what, I've not done. This is how amateur I am. I've not even got my track map loaded.
Oh dear.
I'm doing it now. I'm on it.
I've got mine up, but it's on a different page, and I've got so much to do, to be fair.
Oh,
don't worry about it, Nick. Spin on the formation lap. Don't worry. It's happened to Jenson Button. It happened to George Russell. It's happened to many, many people. Don't worry. So I think even Verstappen did it a couple of weeks ago, didn't he? So
he did, to the best. He did. That one was wet, granted.
Yeah,
but, yes, he did. As the drivers then are coming out, evening lad says Gary 131, obviously missing this race. Come on, Dan. Dan the man says the wall, as the Greek is taking them down towards clearways for the start of this race then. And we're about to be underway. And you see the front four cars are all sort of in a snake-like pattern here, all sort of behind each other, just as Nick Villa gains on them. They're a bit spread out towards the back of the pack, but here we go, Kelly. We're about to get underway.
Here we go, run away. Yeah, absolutely, run away, and it's the Greek that leads them off on the green lap, and he pulls a little bit of a gap, which is about right, from Pony and Winkler in there as well. Start seeing some of the guys coming from the back towards the front as they all kind of spread out as they go down through Paddock Hill Bend and around the hairpin for the first time this evening, as they come back down the hill again, and I forgot which corner these are
Green
now.
Hill.
Oh, and here we go. Here we go. The Greek goes wide, so it's game on already. Winkler is coming up those side. Team Camber, and he's got his teammate behind
the
Pootney as Winkler goes into one. He is. The Greek's off. Winkler's into one. Pootney's in then. He's been overtaken, or side by side with Nick Villa as they go around the GP circuit for the first time this evening, and there's plenty going on as these four, top five or so, just gapped a little bit to the rest of the pack. Excuse me.
Kelly just noticing already early doors here. Laney's got ahead of him, North of Dubs and Exmark, with John Boy and Delore 12th and 13th. So all the Team Prolex boys sort of coming together here. Laney's ahead of the two teammates, and the BMW with Dan, we may see struggling in these dry conditions. But what is Exmark going to do now? This is where we may see the teams sort of play out. Exmark's already lost out to Delore and looked a bit wide there. In fact, has let John Boy go as well. Looked like he was going to let John Boy through. No, so obviously the team game not coming to play for Team Prolex, but Laney has the upper hand. He's just got past Pope Leap on the standings as well. So Laney already at the end of this first lap, looking up the inside of the Greek, who's had a nightmare of a first lap. Laney wanting to get, wanting to show his intent from the sprint race.
Yes, indeed. And as I switched some of the features on, that's better. And Laney on an absolute charge. Gone from the back of the grid to eighth already, and he's on a charge, and he's up the side of the Greek. The Greek, as we said, had a horrendous first lap, unfortunately. And, and two spinners in front of Laney. We got away with that, but, where are we?
It's WSRC Jail Fury.
Look at all this lot, but John Boy also gains places and moves up to 10th place. But he's right in the middle of this gaggle of cars. What a frightening place to be when you're fighting for a championship.
Yeah, he's going to want to get through these cars, Kelly, really quick and get rid of them as soon as possible to get back on that back of Laney. It was Fury and WSRCJ that had the problem there, that had the spin and had the coming together. And how lucky was Laney to get through the middle of that one unscathed here. He's already up into P4, 3 seconds off the back. And as they just come through Hawthorns in towards Westfield now and Dingledale, look at these guys back at the back of this pack here. They are really, really bunched up. And if you're John Boy or Delore, who's mathematically still in this one, you're wanting to get through this pack and get away from them as quick as possible.
Yes.
Because in a pack like this, we've seen many a time happen.
He's doing it, Matt. He's doing it. He's just passed two in that in your last sentence. So he's now... John Boy is now on the back of Fury. Fury's no slouch. He's going to have to work at it to get past him. Fury and Unorthodubs, the next one's in front of him. Laney is in fourth place and improving. He's going quicker. He's got Nick Villa is the next one in front of him. Mm. And he may make short work of Nick Villa, but Emo Guy's in front of him again. And Emo Guy's a fierce competitor. He ain't going to give it up too easily. So, interesting start. Still anyone's game, isn't it?
It is still anybody's game, and John Boy now has got Delore in front of him, so he must have made a mistake somewhere for Delore to get back through, as Delore's very, very wide there. Dan up into P6 just ahead of Fury, as Fury's gone past Dan. Not sure what's happening with Dan here. He's going quite slow. Did he have a bit of a slowdown coming through the Graham Hill Bend? up through that is Surtees towards the Pilgrim's Drop now, and Dan moving out of the way of John Boy, tucking, he looks like he's going to tuck him behind that BMW. Yeah. We've said it all season, he's not the car to be in the wet. Is it next year in the dry, sorry, is it next year though with no McGanns then, as John Boy and Delore both through as they come through Hawthorns, and that is Nick Novilla. Oh, and Jay as well in the background has had a trip to the grass, rejoins fairly easily there and unscathed, but Nick Novilla again has had another trip into the wall here, and not the race Nick Novilla wanted. A bit of a spin on the formation lap, and now he's had a moment there that is not what he'd have wanted. Then who's that going slow? That's Fury slow as well. So Fury's gone slow, and
Emo's up into first, and have we lost somebody, or Laney got past
no,
corner?
Nick Novilla had the spin.
Ah, yes, of course, Nick Novilla had the spin. So Laney up into third and standing on the podium. Wiegler was gone back one, and Emo guy's up in front now. So that's your top three. John Boy is...
We've lost a driver. Got,
Who did we just lose? Who did we lose? Lodder's made a pit stop? No? That's what it says on my screen.
The Greek has retired from the race.
Yes, indeed. And so John Boy now has up into sixth place, but he's got some work to do because Laney is now on the back. He's within a second of Wiegler for, as you can see, he's starting to catch him. So John Boy's got to get on with it if he's going to keep this championship alive.
Yeah, John Boy's got to get a move on. He doesn't want to lose too many points. If he finishes behind Laney in this first race, it's not the end of the world with the feature race coming up, but he needs to damage limitations on them points. He needs to stay as close to Laney as possible, if not finish in front. For Delore here, in front of John Boy, he's got to hope that Laney makes a mistake somewhere. You don't like to say it about drivers making mistakes, but that's what Delore's got to hope for, is that Laney just drops a wheel on the grass or has a bit of a spin, because he needs all the points he can get in this one. But Laney's too experienced to get that one done, and look at him as he's really gaining on the back of Ligaic now, within 0.8 of a second, and only 1.8 off the back of Emo Guy. Both for these two, Andy Kelly as well, both have time penalties.
Oh, as Wiegler goes, has dropped it. I was just about to say, is Wiegler going to play the team game, because he's the brother of Delore, and Delore is still mathematically in this one. I was going to say, is Wiegler going to play the team game, but then he went and dropped it, so that completely ruined my argument on that one.
It did. Delore looks like he's dropped it as well, because he was ahead of John Boy and Unorthodox. He's now behind them both, and really on the tail of Unorthodox is Dan's wide through Paddock Hill Bend as they come down and back up the hill towards Druid's Corner. Now Delore's going to look up the inside, and Dan, plenty of room, plenty of respect. But Dan, if you can hang it around the outside, we'll be on the inside for Graham Hill Bend. But it looks like Delore's got that one done. Dan hanging on in there, though, and he's going to try and keep it up the inside. That's going to force Delore wide. Yeah. That'll possibly be a slowdown and a bit of contact between the two of them. Just forces Delore a bit wider onto the grass. Yeah. Dan slows down immediately to give Delore the place. But that could be a slowdown penalty for Delore, who's very, very wide through Surtees, and he's all into the gravel. He's going to lose out to Nick Novilla there as well. So he's down all the way in P12 and last at the moment. When you need things to go your way dramatically, it always doesn't seem to happen. Delore is slowly getting more and more out of this championship as it goes along.
Sorry, Matt, to jump over you. Look, Laney's in first. I was just about to jump on him anyway, because he had just done Lodder for... I think he'd done Lodder, yeah.
No, he was already ahead of Lodder.
He'd
spun, didn't he?
Spin. Wiegler spun. Laney was in second place. And
wow,
then
Emo.
Emo guy made a mistake, as he's done again just there. So Laney now with a 3-second gap out in front on lap 7.
And
so,
you couldn't dream of a better scenario. Get your head down, get focused, get through these first couple of laps, get that lead. Laney's done exactly that. He's ploughed through the field. There was the incident with Fury, and Jay managed to avoid that one. He's got through the field. He's now got that gap. He doesn't need to look in his mirrors. He knows he's number one. He knows he's P1. He can defend this race for the rest of it. But, I mean, he's 5 seconds in front, so he doesn't even need to defend. His closest championship rival, who we're on board with now, John Boy, is P6, and Exmart is in front of him, doing a job that Laney will be absolutely loving, although he's very wide at Graham Hill Bend, and John Boy's going to have the run down towards Surtees, although he didn't seem to get much of a run there. Maybe a slowdown for Exmart, who stays wide at Surtees, but don't forget, Surtees is a bit of a wider line on entry to the
Exmart's
corner.
Exmart's gone deep.
Exmart
went very, very deep, went very long into that corner, and missed out on that one, so John Boy up into fifth.
From the Greek here, Kelly. He slid into the pit entry and disqualified him. So he's obviously had a bit of a spin towards the pits, and it's disqualified him. That's why he's retired from this race.
Oh dear, that's a shame, isn't it? Yeah, and that happens, doesn't it? You get close to the pit lane, you're going too fast, you get disqualified because it's each being in the pit lane, not having an accident. So, unfortunate for the Greek. He wasn't having the best races, but nobody needs wants to be disqualified. So, that's a shame for him. Now, am I right in saying that John Boy has already won this championship a couple of times before?
Season five, I do believe. I'm not sure about before that, because I think I joined on commentary at Motive in season three. But season five, he was the champion, yeah.
Absolutely. So he's had a taste of this one before, so we know he can win this championship.
He's got that experience as well, Kelly. Sorry to butt in. He's got that experience. Yeah. He took it down to the final day at Zolder to be emo guy for the championship. So he's got that experience of the final day dramas of what to do, what not to do, what's he got to do. He'll know what he's got to do going into this race. And he's been in a situation before where he's got to get it done in that final race. So he's no stranger to this fight going all the way to the end.
Yeah, and am I right in saying that he was in the hunt for the championship last year as well?
John Boy was, he was. With X-Mart, obviously X-Mart managed to take the title.
Yeah, absolutely. So John Boy's got experience in this one. Laney, on the other hand, his first full season in Tier 1, although he was Tier 2 champion, as I believe, and then I think quite
easily... Is
there
a car off? It sounded like there was somebody going a little slow there. Not quite sure.
Pootney's at the back, looking at the track map. Everyone seems to be moving where they should be moving.
Look at the gap lane he's got out front. 7.5 seconds here, yeah. Kelly. He's flying.
Yeah, and as I was saying, Laney, I think, won the Tier 2 last year and then joined Tier 1 late in the season, but was quick straight away. That's the form of these guys. They both know what they're doing. As we see, Vliga has pulled back up to the back of Emo guy. Vliga having a good race. Team Camber, he's got a couple of his mates in here and his brother, Dolores' brother, and another teammate in Pootney. They're all Team Camber.
WSRCJ's in the pits here. Apologies, WSRCJ's in the pits.
Okay.
No, obviously it's not a pit stop race. No. Has he had a drive-through penalty, I wonder, that he's had to get rid of from the stocks? Obviously, Project Cars doesn't make you do it within the three laps. I wonder... Sorry to butt in there, Kelly. What's happened to Laney? Laney's dropped to P4. He's dropped behind John Boy. There's Laney. Laney stopped on track.
What's happened?
Oh, he's disconnected.
Oh, no. He's gone.
Laney's not going to score a point.
Oh, he can get back in for the next race, but...
He can get back in, but he's not going to score for this first one.
He's not going to score any points. He's out in front, disconnected. Oh, that's like the virtual world version of a blown-up engine, isn't it? Really?
Wow.
Do you know what I mean? There's nothing you can do about it. It's out of your control, but he's disconnected. So, could this be the turning point of this championship here?
So this throws the pendulum in John Boy's favour here. Delore, P9, he could really do now. We've seen Laney disconnect, getting a wiggle on to get a few more positions here, because the few more positions he can get will close them points to Laney. 63, I think, is the gap. Obviously, with the points still up for grabs at the moment, 62 is the gap between Delore and Laney. So with Laney going, Delore really needs to get a wiggle on to get some positions and really close that gap between himself and Laney.
We just lose someone else.
Yeah, we've lost WSRCJ.
Yeah, he's just gone as well. So we're down to 10 drivers in this sort of disconnections and problems for many people.
I don't think Jay's disconnected here. I think Jay's retired. You see the two dots stationary in the pit lane on the track map. I also didn't see Jay's name pop up as a disconnection. So the Greek and Jay both retired to the pits. Obviously, we know the Greek span and got disqualified in the pit lane. Not sure about Jay, but ex-Martin Dan here, they could really play havoc in this championship by trying to limit the points that John Boy and Glory are going to score. John Boy's just gone up into P3. And if he can get on the back of these leaders with time penalties, Kelly, John Boy could win this race. There we see a 3 second for Emo guy and a 2 second for Vlee. Also 6 for Nick the Villa and 5 for Pokeney. So all he's got to do is be within 3 seconds of that leader. He's 4.1 off the back of the lead at the minute. And John Boy's going to win this race. And that is huge points to swing in his favour.
Yes, and don't feel like John Boy's all of a sudden just found another gear. We've been watching him go round and round and round. All of a sudden, now he's in the now Laney's gone. He seems to have just picked the pace up a little bit, and maybe sat back up in the seat a little bit more and got a wiggle on, because this is a real opportunity when it was all going downhill. And this is the beauty of motor racing, isn't it? And as I said, the disconnection. You know, you could kind of somebody goes very, very sideways. Whoever that, there's two behind. Look, fight with John Boy, which is Lotta and Fury. Having a nice little scrap, but I was going to say that you can kind of moan and groan, oh, sim racing, internet connections, blah blah blah. But as I said, if you know, in the real world, you can blow an engine up, snap a drive shaft, have a puncture, any of those things that you know that don't happen in the sim world quite so often. So we've all got our fair share of swings and roundabouts, really. So you know, as it was just all falling apart for John Boy, all of a sudden it's just come back to him again, and it's going to give us a very interesting feature race.
It really is. He's within the 3.3 second mark now of Emo Guy, and with 7.5 minutes remaining, he's well on course to get on the back of Emo Guy and Vlee, and maybe even pass them two. What dramas we got here. But Fury at the moment having a cracking little race here on the back of Lotta, 4P4 and 5. And if Fury, he's looking racy, he's got the pace, 129.9, quickest man on track last lap, Kelly. So Fury really looking like he's got the bit between his teeth. If he can jump in front of Lotta, could Fury find himself on the podium with the time penalties of the front two?
Very possibly. We've talked about Fury a bit this season, haven't we? And how he's so improved his game this season. I'm going to be up against him on track. Over on Simplay as from Wednesday night when the new season starts over there. Cheeky little plug, did you like that?
Yeah,
and,
brilliant.
I'll be racing against this man Fury, and I hate to say it, but he's getting better and better every week, you know, and less mistakes, more pace.
X-Mart's in the pits. Now, this is strange tonight. He's got no fuel.
No fuel.
So the current defending champion, lack of fuel in for this sprint race. Wow, that's not something you'd have expected to see. He's been held as well a little bit in the pits. He's going to now finish right at the back of the pack. That's allowed Delore up into P7 here. John Boy's within the 3 seconds he needs to be of Emo Guy, and nearly within that 2 seconds of Vliegerk. He is within the 2 seconds of Vliegerk, so he's well on course here for this race win. And what a points win. But you're right about Fury, Kelly. He seems to have, as the season's progressed here, he seems to have got better and better and grown in confidence. And you've seen his pace improve all the time.
Yeah, he's less mistakes from Fury. He was quite leery when I first started watching him, and had pace, but also didn't seem to have control. But seems to have been sharpening his game up quite a lot. So, as I said, he's going to be a real, for me, he's going to be a real guy to watch, a real contender over on Simplay when we start on Wednesday. So Fury going really well. But as you say, John Boy is, well, it's 2 seconds, 2 seconds off the lead now. So
He's flying. 28.29.9 again. Quickest man on track that last lap so far. He is flying at the moment. Vlee, though, hats off to Vlee at the moment. He's really keeping up with Emo Guy and putting Ian under some massive pressure. And if Lai can keep himself with the time penalties and keep himself within the Emo Guy's time penalties, he will beat him on them at the end of this race, unless he manages to do it on the track. As Christian Fay in the chat says, vroom, and they are vrooming indeed. Oh, Emo Guy's wide, and has Vlee got the run out of Surtees towards Pilgrim's Drop? No, he's tucked back in behind Flat Slipstream, but look in the background, the lights are on that green McGann of John Boy's. He means business. He's going for this race win on outright pace. He's within a second nearly now of Emo Guy, and Kelly, he is flying.
Yes, he is. He's got the bit between his teeth, hasn't he? Because it's like a carrot that says championship on it, and he's chasing it for sure. As the top two are still scrapping over the first place at the moment, which is helping. Vlee goes real sideways as they come up to the top part of the circuit, and John Boy's right on him now. Look, let's hope they don't crash into him, of course. Oh, commentators go, sorry, John Boy. If it all goes terribly wrong, I'm so sorry.
He's right on the back of them now, isn't he? He's about to start lap.
You've got to be nervous there, Matt, haven't you? You've got to be nervous now.
What do you do if you're John Boy, Kelly? Do you take the points, or do you think, now I've got to go for that win, I need every advantage I can get? John Boy, looking at the way he's going, he wants every advantage he can get over Laney going into that final race.
He's got the race win right now. I mean, he's done Vita now, so he's done that, and he's within 3 seconds easily of Emo Guy. So, I mean, the race win is his. What do you do? Do you know what I mean? I mean, that Veliga pace that he's just taken was easy me. Veliga went deep or let him through. I don't know which it was, but that was easy.
Sorry, carry on.
I was going to say, what do you do in that position? He's won this race. If he has a go at Emo Guy and it goes wrong, he could be just tumbling back down through the order and losing points hand over fist. This is a race win, but it's not on. It won't be on position, but it will be on penalties. But it will be a race win, and you've got to be thinking championship. What do you do, Matt?
Me personally, I try to stay to as close as I can to the back of Lee and Emo Guy and get that race win on the time penalties instead of on the track. Try and keep myself within that time limit. Like you say, you don't want to get caught up over anybody. I suppose for John Boy, if he does, you see him getting all sideways through.
He gave a nudge to Emo Guy as well, I think.
Where was that? That was coming through. Where are we? Sheen Kerr.
Yeah.
I'd be kind of tempted to sit behind Emo Guy here and just make sure I follow him home and not push too hard. No matter what happens, no matter where he finishes, he's gaining points over Laney, with Laney not scoring a single point. But John Boy is a racer. We're all racers. He's got Emo Guy.
He's gone through, yeah.
I was about to say this a minute ago. Vlee and Emo Guy there haven't fought that, and they know it's not their fight. They don't want to be the guy that's caused John Boy to maybe lose a championship because they got involved and because they fought him too hard. Emo Guy's clever enough to know that he's not won that race while John Boy's on his tail.
Yeah, these two both know that. They know exactly that. So they can see the time penalties better than we can. It comes up on their screen all the time. So they know exactly what's going on. And Emo Guy has been around long enough to know exactly what's going on. As you said, neither one of them fought him very hard. So I think they just, you know, let the championship run its course. They can't, it's not their battle. Stay out of it, you know. And it looks like that's maybe what's been done. Vigla and Emo Guy are probably the closest together of anybody on the track at the moment. We have kind of spaced out quite a lot.
Fury's dropped off the back a lot, or hasn't he, a few seconds? He's not really able to get that one done. Just looking down the pack as well, Delore's catching Nick the Villa, but again it's a couple of seconds between them. Dan's kind of on his own, as we see now, and look at that BMW.
What's he done to that?
That looks like Andy needs plowed through the side of him, in all fairness. That looks like he's had a few rolls.
Looks like he's had an incident with Andy Neat, the way that car's looking.
I think he's drove right through. I'm saying that, so does Nick the Villa, looking at that McGann as well. But Delore here gaining points on Laney, losing points to John Boy. So John Boy is probably going to be the championship leader come the end of this race. Is Delore out of it? Not 100% sure. But he's not had the pace we saw in the practice session. Was second quickest, don't forget, in the practice session just before this race. And hasn't shown the pace. He's not like he's been caught up in incidents. His car looks well intact as Vlee in the background was side by side coming through Graham Hill Bend with Emo Guy, and Emo Guy still hanging on to that final, it's that second place spot. Wants this podium bad. These two are bound to get the podium unless they've got any more time penalties. Emo Guy a bit wide on exit, getting off the grass. You want to get it back on the tarmac as quick as you can. Now down through Pilgrim's Drop, what is Vlee going to do? He's going to have that toe as they come down towards Hawthorns, where John Boy's just going through now. Emo Guy defends the inside of Hawthorns, very quick corner, just down a gear, back on the power mid-corner and get it round. Emo Guy looks like he's just struggling a little bit towards the end of this race, in towards Westfield and Dingle Dell now, like a double sort of right-hander, but two corners on their own up the hill towards Sheen Curve, and Vlee here doing bits.
Yes, it dropped off the pace just a little bit there. Again, they know Vigla has got a 1 second penalty and Gary's got a three, so he knows he's going to be in front of him unless he's picked up any more penalties since we checked. But it's going to be this man who's going to take the win and bring the champion, goes in front in the championship, and it's going to be John Boy who's going to be very happy with that win. First place, Emo Guy comes over the line in second. Vinica actually gets him on time penalties, come over there. Oh, Lodder goes into second on time penalties, Matt.
Wow.
Excuse me.
So they must have picked. They must have wrapped up a few more penalties than what we saw originally. Fury gets P5 with Nick the Villa, Delore, Unorthodox, Pokeneep, and Exmark bringing home the rest of the field. Delore, P6. Is that his title done now that John Boy's won the race?
Wow. Sorry, I was just taking a drink there. Wow. How's your mathematics?
Not too bad. Not too bad.
Not too bad. Well, I'll leave it to you to do the mathematics.
I don't know the points.
Oh, I can give you the points. Well, I know the points. I've got the points.
Yes, give me the points.
I've got the point system. So, first place is 35 points. So, I believe that John Boy was 6 points behind.
So, what was that?
Laney.
35.
So, he should be.
So, I'll put him on 408.
29 points in front, wouldn't he?
Yeah. Yes, I'll put him on 308. 408, sorry. So, he'll be 26 points in front of Laney.
Yeah.
And Delore, what did he score for P6?
For P6, he got 20 points. So then...
Yeah, he's 68 points behind, and with only 35 points for the win, he's out.
35. So there's only 36 points left. Do we get a point fastest lap? No, we don't, do we? No, it's just the... just a straight point. So yeah, so that's Delore out of it.
You do get a point.
Fastest lap went to John Boy. So John Boy's 27 points ahead of Laney then, because the fastest lap went to John Boy in that race. So Laney's got to turn around a 27 point swing here. We've not scored any points that race. Delore's out of it, and John Boy really is in the box seat going into this feature race.
Absolutely, and that's the way I read it anyway. So. We'll probably take a short break here, is what I'm guessing.
Yeah.
And we will be doing the qualifying for the feature race and the championship decider. So it's going to be exciting. Don't go away. Do what you got to do. Be back here in about 3 minutes.
The separation of talent and skill is one of the greatest misunderstood concepts for people who are trying to excel, who have dreams, that want to do things. Talent you have naturally. Skill is only developed by hours and hours and hours of beating on your craft. There's no easy way around it. No matter how talented you are, your talent is going to fail you if you're not skilled. You know, if you don't study, if you don't work really hard and dedicate yourself to being better every single day. Make a choice. Like, you just decide what it's going to be, who you're going to be, how you're going to do it. Just decide.
I'm motivated by...
As managed to keep it just ahead of Dwayne Buffett at the moment, as we're side by side here coming down the pit straight. Is Tamba going to make this three wide coming towards turn one? You can see there Dwayne Buffett just trying to squeeze Emo Guy towards the right, giving him the middle of that space. We're three wide coming into turn one. Camber very sensibly backs out of that one as Emo Guy manages to hold his position on the inside line and just about squeeze his way into the position there and maintains 8th place ahead of Dwayne Buffett.
Here we go, and it looks like we're lights out here at Brands Hatch, and it's a good start there from Pole from BT Targa. And it looks like we've already got Fury coming down the middle here, coming towards Paddock Hill. BT Targa trying to fend off Seba Stefano as he comes onto the brakes. It looks like he has held onto the lead just about, but Surtees is hassling him as he comes through Druids, and we see there Fury's managed to get that position on Oakbar into Druids. Seba Stefano very late on the brakes there, and looks like BT Targa's been pushed out a little bit. So Seba Stefano's up into the lead. Looks like Fury having a look on BT Targa, but BT Targa managed to hold on to that P2. Just appears when BT Targa emerges from the pit lane. We know that a pit stop is around 25 seconds, and he's going to be very close with Rompu as he comes to the end of the pit lane now. Rompu drives around the outside of Paddock Hill and up into third place. So that would have not been what BT Targa wanted at all.
Second separating these boys. Thorsten did have a lead of about 3 or 4 seconds. He was pulling away to his Egan Milk for a few laps, and now he pulls out to the left-hand side. Ziegen Milk has to leave the door open. We're going to go side by side here down the pit straight. Is Thorsten going to go for the move into the first corner? It looks like he does. He's up the inside. So Thorsten Borchardt getting that position. Side by side here down the pit straight. Oscar Steyl now has an opportunity to take this P2 position. We're side by side coming out towards turn one. Oscar Steyl goes later on the brakes up the inside. Elliot tries to undercut him on the exit. Still side by side. Incredible stuff. Can Elliot hold it around the outside here? Or is Oscar Steyl going to complete the move? It looks like Elliot somehow managing to hold on to that position.
To go for the move. Both of these guys within about 2/10 of the car in front. As we see the Hewish Rocker closing speed coming onto the brakes. So he looks like he's making the move up the inside here.
of bunny prevention, but he can't quite get it done at the moment. Lewis goes a little bit wide there on the exit, and it looks like he almost spins it. Very close there to losing the car. HRT Zeus is up into second place, but Lewis Rucker was pushing a little bit too hard there in his quest to try and get ahead of bunny prevention. Bunny prevention's holding on to the lead.
Got Hideku lining ratchet ass up here, but he can't quite make it stick at the moment by the looks of it. Unorthodox has got a fantastic run on both of these guys, but Unorthodox, you just saw, had to get out of it a little bit there because he had a great run. It was going to most likely end up in him driving himself into trouble, and we can see Ratchet Ass going straight on there over the chicane. Unorthodox driving around the outside there of B Decker and up into fifth place, and all Unorthodox looks like he's going to try and get Ratchet Ass as well. He has indeed. That is brilliant stuff from Unorthodox.
Reaching in every way that he can. John Boy very much on the back of these guys now as they come down the pit straight. Oh, we can see there, it looks like they're going to get a loose there onto the grass, and now Little Lee just going to fancy his charges around the outside, and with three wide here coming out of the pit straight, John Boy trying to get involved in this action as well. In the end, I think surely Little Lee is going to back out. Yes, he does, but John Boy making a double overtake there coming into turn one, and he's up into sixth place. What a move there from
pushing. You can tell he's pushing. Look at the way he's driving the car. He's making sure it's got nothing left to give. He's absolutely ragging it round Altupong. He's got alongside Exmoor as they're headed towards the island bend. Gary will have the inside line, and Exmoor's wide, and he's off. Can he keep it out of the tyre wall? Indeed he does.
In fact, he's through, coming through the little chicane section there, and already going down the back straight. He's going to try and get Laney needs roughly 27 points to beat John Boy.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the final round of the season here at Motive Racing, the British Touring Car season, our British Touring Car season on Motive Racing. We are at Brands Hatch GP for the last race of the season, and it's high drama here at the moment. If you've only just joined us, where have you been? Because we had a cracking first sprint race where we saw John Boy win the race and take points off his championship contender or championship rival Laney, and goes up to the top of the championship. So it's all to play for. It's between John Boy and Laney, and we believe with our
roughly
poor mathematics
roughly
27 roughly 27 points behind. I'm joined once again in the commentary box, sweet and sticky in your box, it's Matthew Duffin. How are you, Matt?
I'm great, Kelly. That's never going to get old. That's going to stick with
ever
us now till the end of time. And yeah, roughly, if my maths are correct, and from guys who have previously watched Renault Clio races, my maths are normally right. I got the maths right one time with Dan, but it was the wrong names and the drivers between G and Morgan. Roughly 27 points. We believe Laney is now behind John Boy, so we'll need 28 points or more to outscore him by 28 points or more, which, Kelly, is not an easy feat.
No, 36 points available for the win and fastest lap. So 35 for the win, one for the fastest lap. So that's the maximum points available. 30 for second, 27 for third. So to be fair, Laney needs to be, or he needs to be third with John Boy not scoring. He really needs to be third or higher without John Boy scoring, and then it would be, I think there's a lot of permutations to this one, to be fair. And I ain't Carol Vorderman, so you know, we'll work it out as we go, hopefully
we'll work it out as we go. What do you get for 13th and 14th, Kelly?
For 13th and 14th, it is 13th is 4 points and 14th is 3 points. Okay, so if Laney won this one with fastest lap, that would make 36 points. So John Boy would have to come 12th or higher?
Yeah.
12th or higher to win, yeah. I think. Yeah.
Well, what's the point? What's the points for 11th?
Points for 11th are 7 points.
So 36 take 7 is 29. So no, what's the points for 10?
9.
So if John Boy gets 10th, that'll score him 27. That'll score him 9 points. If Laney won the race with fastest lap, that'll be 27. So they may roughly be tied on point. We think they'll be tied on points if that's the case, because there'll be a 27 point difference between them. So basically, if John Boy gets 9th or higher, he's won the title.
That's what we reckon. If anybody's better at mathematics and wants to do the working out by going on to, I believe all the standings are on the Motive website. I don't know, maybe. Yeah, if you feel like doing the maths yourself, that's up to you. Otherwise, you'll have to take our word for it. So Laney needs to win the race and fastest lap, and John Boy only needs to be 10th or higher,
9th,
to win the championship, we believe.
9th. Yeah, we're good at this, Kelly. Sweet and sticky. We're good at this.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've got all the permutations.
Brundle and Crofty who? Sorry?
Yeah, exactly.
Never heard of them.
Harvey and Addison who?
Never heard of them.
Yeah,
never heard of them.
Neither have I.
I can't think of any other famous ones. I mean, only other famous one I can think of is Murray Walker and James Hunt. And I don't want to diss either of them because they're both legends.
Yeah, both legends and commentating on some great races here.
Yeah. Great races up above us. Hanging out with Prince and David Bowie. So, they're having a whale of a time. But back here on planet Earth and on the virtual world, you're with Sweet and Sticky. And we are your commentary team. And I hate to say it, we're probably the best. My missus just said Laurel and Hardy. She, you know what she likes. She hardly ever speaks. And then she just said, I said that and paused. And she went, Laurel and Hardy. Like that. How rude, isn't it?
Yeah, I agree.
How rude.
I agree.
Absolutely. More Morecambe and Wise. Or Chuckle Brothers. To me.
Yeah, to you.
Boom! Real evening.
Brilliant. Oh, we, as you can see, though, we've got a wet qualifying with 9 minutes left of this one. So expect Dan and Gary to have a bit of pace in this qualifying. But look who's setting the pace. Half a second quicker than his rival, John Boy.
John Boy's got the bit between his teeth. He'll know that all he needs is a solid result in this one. And the championship's his. And he's been there before. And he wants to be there again. So he'll know this. He'll know what he's got to do. And, he doesn't have to win this one. He just has to bring it home. He just has to do the Fernando Alonso, the Colin Turkington, the X-Mart, and be consistent and just bring it home.
Matt Neal. Did you see? I nearly cried today. Did you see how many times I went to Matt Neal and he's like, oh, he didn't look right in his jeans and his official headset on.
Sad?
And, I looked sad.
Right, I tell you what. Those of you who tune into both the best sim leagues on YouTube, being Motive Racing and SimPlay, those of you who tune into SimPlay, we did a 24-hour about 10 days ago for Shabin Smith, and we raised a lot of money, £1,300.
Yeah.
Thank you to everyone that was involved
in that.
But there is talk of another 24-hour, and I believe that I have got the best charity for this one. And ladies and gentlemen, get behind this one with me. We're going to try and get some counselling for Matthew Duffin over this really quite unhealthy obsession
fanboy obsession.
And with Matt Neal. Do you know what I mean? And it's really getting a little bit worrying, and I'm concerned for him. And I want everyone to get on board. We need the straighten out Matt Duffin appeal, to get him off this nasty Honda habit and this Matt Neal thing. Do you know what I mean? We can get him clean. Come on, guys. So next 24, that's what we need to be doing.
I think we need to raise some money to get Matt Neal back in the car this season and replace. He doesn't need it. Just show our support. We'll give the money to charity, but make art it's for him and show our support to get back in the car.
I'm sorry, I don't think I can commit to this one. And it's obvious that your habit is getting worse and not better. And I think you need some serious help, my friend. Just saying.
I think I'm gonna have to get a Matt Neal shrine going just for you, Kelly. Just so I can send you a picture of a little Matt Neal shrine.
I can imagine you had some little kind of. I'm imagining this steel locker, like a school type locker, right? That you open, and then there's all these pictures of Matt Neal.
Yeah,
in there.
Love hearts on them, and I kiss one every morning for good luck.
A little Honda badge, Honda badge, right in the middle of it, like this locker type shrine.
You're not far away. What it is above my
above
my desk, above my two monitors here, is I've got a shelf. And on my shelf, I've got a massive picture of Matt Neal in his Hondas with Gordon Shedden on the bottom from that season. It was that season's picture. So it's like a top half Matt Neal, bottom half Gordon Shedden. And then I've got a model car that the touring cars sort of released of when Matt Neal won the championship in 06 in his Honda Integra Type R on my shelf, along with the Green Bay Packers NFL quarterback that I really like, along with a picture alongside that. But that's my main picture on my shelf, the Matt Neal sort of shelf. I want to add to that.
Well, yeah. As I've just said, ladies and gentlemen, I rest my case. What have you just heard out there, everyone? I rest my case. We need to help this guy. Come on.
Did Dan not show you, did Dan not show you the picture from earlier today?
The picture? Sat down a lovely picture.
Yeah, no, sat down a lovely picture of me in my Honda hat.
No, I didn't see that one. And to be fair, I was probably eating and didn't want to vomit. So, you know, so it's probably best that Dan didn't show me that one. But, yes, come on, guys. We need to get behind this one. We need to get this guy straight, don't we? Sure. I mean, listen to what you're hearing.
His granddad in the comments just said, no wonder Beth supports Gary.
and Dan, you know, so... That's what we'll do next time. We'll help you, Matt. Don't worry. You're amongst
Cheers,
friends.
Guys.
We'll get you
Cheers,
out of this.
Guys.
So back to the championship in hand. Not a Honda in sight in this one. Not a single solitary lawnmower anywhere.
Do you know what I'm looking forward to? I'm looking forward to the touring car game next year, because I can't wait to see how many Hondas people are going to pick. In fact, guys, if Motive run the touring car league next year, when the game gets released, if Motive do a league on it, let's all drive the Honda in support of Kelly Davis, in support of Sticky. Again, let's get as many Hondas on the grid in support of Sticky next year. Let's do this.
He can't help himself. Listen to him. Ladies and gentlemen, look, listen to him. He can't help himself. It's just this addiction is such a dirty thing, you know, and we can help Matt Duffin. We really can. I believe in my heart we can do it.
I tell you one thing we're noticing here, Kelly. Sorry to again butt
yes.
in. The BMW's
sorry to get
fourth.
Back to reality.
To get back to reality. Fourth and fifth, not as far.
No.
You know, Gary's 1 second off the pace. Dan's only half a second, but not the pace we've come to see from the BMWs in the wet at the moment.
Yeah. Absolutely, because you and me both said when we heard it was a wet qualifying for this one, we said, I said that's Dan on pole, and you said, either that or Gary. We know how strong these BMWs are in the wet. And as Daniel puts it, a lovely little slide around the corner as he comes down the hill. But we know how strong these Beamers are in the wet. They've got a couple of minutes left to do it. But the man who's quick is John Boy. And to be fair, John Boy has always been the quick one in the wet behind the BMWs, hasn't he?
He's kind of been the lead McGann in the wet races, hasn't he, behind the BMWs. The BMW's been in a class of their own. He's kind of been the lead McGann out of the rest of the field when it has been wet. Only 23 thousandths quicker than Lodder at the moment. Lodder having a cracking qualifying. But Laney, half a second behind in the pits. And, you know, 1.5 minute a lap. He's only going to get one flying lap in if he leaves the pit now. Is Laney done? I mean, the conditions obviously just getting worse, so he's not going to improve. But it's not. It's put Laney. It's another on the back foot for Laney in this qualifying session, isn't it?
It is, and you know, touring car, unlike Formula One, that you know, of course, qualifying is important, but not quite as important. Do you know what I mean? If he's in the top three, then he's in the hunt, isn't he? You know, and we've seen how quickly things can change in a touring car race, sim or real, you know? So, you know, qualifying, of course, is important, but not as important. You know, you don't have to be on pole to win this race.
You don't. Going back to a fantasy world, fantasy touring cars, we run a page over at Simplay. Kelly Davis, 18th out of 18.
Yep, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I am going with a radical strategy that may pay me off next later in the season, of course.
I'm eighth. I'm sort of mid-pack, the old Plato
Punterino.
The Plato Punterino team. I was last.
You was last. You and Beth were both last at one point. So don't give me all that, because
It can swing.
It can swing, absolutely. And my strategy...
One person yesterday after qualifying, Jamie Brazier's partner, had 0 points after qualifying. The only person to not score a point after the qualifying in the Fantasy League. Now sits seventh. So it can change as quick as that. But you are losing to a guy who's got Nick Hamilton, Andy Neat and Glyn Geddie in his team. So
yes, okay. Yeah. If anybody hasn't, let me just explain this real quickly. If anybody isn't done the Fantasy League, then it's great fun. Please do have a go. It's on the British Touring Car website, and there is a Simplay League for this, right? So you get the choice, or you get credits, don't you? You get so many credits, and each driver is worth so many credits. Anyone who's done a fantasy thing before will probably understand this, right?
Yeah.
So I've gone for a radical strategy of spending all my credits on three incredibly good drivers. Okay, so I've gone for Gordon Shedden, Colin Turkington, and who was the other one?
Tom Ingram.
Tom Ingram, just because I really like Tom Ingram. So Tom Ingram is one of my is my guilty pleasure. The other two are solid race winning, championship winning guys, right? Yeah. So I've thrown all my money at those three. So that's my strategy. I don't get six drivers, you know, because I've eked out my. You know, I haven't gone for one good driver and five rubbish ones. I've gone for three top-class, top-draw drivers to see if I can do well like that. So far, after round one, it ain't panning out so well. Oh, Dan has a bit of a spin there.
Yeah, a bit of a spin.
And stays there, holds position as somebody comes through. That's it. Good boy. And, yeah, so that's my philosophy on it, but it ain't panning out so well just yet. I haven't even looked at my Formula One yet. So,
the Formula One's
not doing very well in that.
Yeah, the Formula One's not been updated. But what I will say to you is, you've obviously got the King of Croft in there in terms of Turkington. You've got Shedden, who's family owned Knockhill. So, you know, kind of his home, it really is his home circuit. So, you've got racers coming up that you could score big. John Boy, though, on pole. No one else can touch him.
John Boy is on pole. Yep. And the championship fight is right there because Laney's right there with him in third place. Best of the Beamers is Daniel at the moment, but Gary's still on a flyer by the looks of it. So we'll see where he ends up. He could still steal this one. He's a bit raggedy round there. Fighting that BMW like there's no air in the tyres.
Oh, that's Dan in the wall again there. So he's had another spin. These BMWs in the wet haven't looked as convincing round here as we expected.
No. No, absolutely not. I expected a BMW 1-2 in qualifying, but not the case around this brand's circuit. It didn't seem to suit them very well at all, does it? But I don't think Gary's going to go quicker with this one. It seems to be very leery. But we've seen Gary go quick before, and when it's all hanging out as well. So well, it's coming across the line. We'll see what he does, see if he improves.
No improvement.
And he does not. No, I didn't think it was a better one. Dan had a trip into the wall, so he's... and he's having a bit of a play with that one. So that's it. That's your qualifying. So, championship leader, John Boy, on pole with... what did he do? 134.4. That's reasonably quick in the wet because the guys... there we go. And the screen's gone already. So it's John Boy on pole. Lodder, good effort. Good effort being second place. There on the grid, and Laney lines up right behind in second place. In third place on the grid, and second place in this championship. So he's got a Felipe Massa kind of job here to do. He needs to go off and win the race and hope that that man in front of him doesn't and crashes out, disconnects, comes worse than 10th. That's what he's got to be hoping, because all Laney can do is his very best. But it may not be enough.
It may not be enough, but we'll have to wait and see what Laney can do. The touring cars is a wonderful, wonderful package, wonderful season that we've had here at Motive. We've had some cracking races throughout the season. Sweet and Sticky in and out of the commentary box. Obviously, Dan decided to give us the weekend off last weekend.
Yeah, bless
you. Due to the 24-hour race. But it is the season finale, the final race of the season, and it's going to be sad to see these touring cars go, because what a season we've had. And I'm sure Laney will wish after that first race he could have another two races after this one just to try and claw back that championship. But like you say, John Boy, 9th or better, and he's won this title. And it's hard to look past John Boy getting ninth, lower than 9th, isn't it?
Yeah. It is, but anything could happen. 26 laps of racing. There is a mandatory pit stop in this one. Lap 8, the pit window opens. Yep. So, guys, don't have to change tyres, don't have to do fuel, just have to do that pit stop. But that can shake things up as well. So there's a lot to do. There's many, many times a championship has been looked done and dusted at the beginning of the last race and all fallen apart. So we're just syncing up now, so we're ready to go. This is a standing start on this one. as we hear the lights. And away we go. A very quick start from someone at the back. I don't know who that was, but...
look at two BMWs. Look at Gary. Oh, no!
And they've taken, and as I said, they've taken... Oh, I thought they took Laney, but they haven't taken Laney.
No, it was Lauda.
Yeah, so the BMWs go backwards, right to the back. They took Lauda with them, and certainly can't be blamed for spoiling a championship with that one. They took the wrong McGann, so we've still got a championship fight on our hands. But Laney, this is right as we start, this is not going to be enough for Laney. He's going to have to win this one, and John Boy's going to have to have an absolute shocker, and I hope these two race cleanly and fairly, which I'm sure they will. They're both very experienced, but they're away. Look at the gap. Back to who's in third? Look at Fury, good boy, up into third from that one. And Exmart, the reigning champion, just for the next 26 laps. Exmart, there he goes. He's up into fourth place. Delore just behind him. Delore's out of this one now. Fury's flying. He's catching back up the back of these two real quickly.
I think Laney's had a bit of a slowdown penalty there, Kelly, as Fury is right on the back of him at the moment. Exmart and Glory, fourth and fifth, they're in a good little battle as well. But what happened at the start, says Iron Brew Racing? Well, what did happen? I'll tell you what happened. Gary went one way, Dan went the other, Lauda in the middle, and they all just sort of met in one spot.
Yeah,
and all three of them went exit
stage.
Yeah, they did. And all three went exit stage left. But you couldn't make it up. Laney, slowdown, time penalty added at the end of this race already.
Of how much? That's what we need to probably only be a second, won't it, for a 1 second at the moment for Laney, who's managed to we think now. He may have had a slowdown, but he's back on the pace again now. John Boy doing more than he needs to do. If he stays where he is, it's an easy championship win for him.
Kelly, pit window's not till lap 8, but we've got Emo Guy and Jay in the pits straight away.
Well, that's bizarre, isn't it? Why have they done that?
Hang on. Have they left the wet tyre on from qualifying?
Well, maybe. Maybe.
Oh, Laney's in the lead. What's happened to John Boy? Laney leads. John Boy's down to third.
What happened?
Fury's mum in the chat saying, go for it, Fury. The wall, X-Mart hello. Hope to see you in the next season of the GT4s. X-Mart, big, huge
X-Mart
spin.
Loses it.
Wow, what's going on here? John Boy's back up to speed, though. It only looks like he's lost a couple of places. Maybe a slowdown, as the car looks fine.
That was a big slowdown. That was a huge slowdown. If he, mind you, it can be that way.
We've lost Jay from the final race.
And we've lost Jay. It's all happening here at the moment, isn't it? Probably two guys on the wrong tyres. Had to change back, say, because we had a wet qualifying. John Boy went from first to third. Laney's out in front and flying now. Fury up to second. The BMW's had a shocker, but are back in the midfield already. Yeah. And we're only at the start of lap 3.
And you saw Gary there in the background, just coming across the line, really on the back of Nick Davila. So Gary pumped up for this one. Dan just a further bit behind. But look at Gary on the back of Nick Davila as they come through Paddock Hill Bend up towards Druids. Is he going to look to send one up the inside? No. As Nick covers that inside line, and look at the state of that BMW. Seen better days, haven't it?
Yeah, that looks like it's been in some sort of kinky Lotta sandwich with another BMW. Oh, the one behind us all smashed up as well. look at the state of that. That looks like one of the ones that hangs around McDonald's and goes drifting on a Sunday. Absolutely beat to death. And usually got big black smoke coming out the back of it. You know the type.
Yeah.
We all know the type.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a dirty BMW. And that looks like one, that one. It doesn't look like a competition one for sure. But Gary... the two BMWs, they were dead last after the first start incident, but now they're up to 6th and 7th at the moment. Other guys had problems, of course. X-Mart has had a spin, Emo Guy's been in the pits, and John Boy's got back in front of Fury.
Yeah, I was just about to say that.
Yep, and now he's, he doesn't have to chase after Laney. He can just sit back and just... cruise his way to the end on this one, to be fair.
Yeah, he didn't really have to get past Fury. I didn't know if Fury got out of shape or made a mistake or something, but John Boy here, we said in race one, does he need to go for that race win? He went for it, he got it. That is Nick Davila, very, very wide, still on the gravel, playing in the sand more than racing around Brands Hatch as he rejoins the circuit now, and that's another place for the two BMW drivers. But you have to say for John Boy here, after race one, when it was, does he push for that race win, and he clearly did. here he's just got to be in cruise control and make sure he doesn't finish lower than ninth.
Well, you say that, Matt, but we're all racers. All of us just get involved in this. And to quote a very famous film that we all know, doesn't matter if you win by an inch or a mile, winning is winning, and we all want to win. That's the problem, you know. So will John Boy have a sniff at a win and want to take it in style and come over the line as the winner? We will see. He's certainly got pace, but so is his championship contender has got pace as well. So see how this race pans out. We're on lap four. We've had drama already, plenty of it. Two smashed up BMWs, and Gary's looks like a compact now. It's had such a hard hit, and but he's still chasing. He's still got pace. Dan's just behind him with the other smashed up compact, and
matching the pace of the front runners as well. Kelly, looking at Gary's lap times, 30.1. That's the same as what. In fact, Gary was just a couple of hundredths quicker than John Boy last time around, to quicker than every car in front of him, bar Laney. And Dan, again, not too far off of Gary's pace. So Gary, where's this pace been for the BMWs in the dry all season? We've seen them at tracks in the dry where they've been like half a second slower. And here, they look on the pace, whereas in the wet, in qualifying, they didn't seem to have the pace.
Well, it seems to be that Brands is a bit of a strange track for the BMW, being that it might be quick in the dry and not so clever in the wet, as we're used to being the other way around with the BMWs. But certainly seems, Gary and Dan's in the 131s now, the low 31s. Gary's about a second a lap quicker than him at this time. Laney, the fastest man on the track at the moment, with a 29.3, a second
Fury's
faster
back in front
than
of John
Fury,
Boy.
Who's got in front of John Boy again, hasn't he?
And John Boy's got himself a slowdown penalty to go with that one as well, Kelly. So he's struggling a bit. Dan's just picked himself up a slowdown penalty. So has the Greek. So a few time penalties coming in here. And Gary, you've got Fury, John Boy, Delory, Pokeneep, and then Gary. Pokeneep, P5 at the minute. Great race for Pokeneep so far.
Yeah, going really, really well. Yes, indeed, on the last tour for this season. It's so easy to say, isn't it? Yeah. Next season, the Renault Meganes are gone. No more Renault Meganes. So it's only Astras, Mercedes and BMWs.
Ooh, John Boy
goes deep. So easy to do there, but it harms you so badly. As we can see him chasing Fury down. And there's quite a gaggle of cars in this one, to be fair. There's Delore just having a watching brief on this battle, really. And behind that, Pokeneep, as you spoke about, Team Camber, is in this fight as well. It's Gary in the BMW. They're just gapping him slightly. Dan, again, going back a little way. Dan's got a little bit of work to do, but certainly these guys all in the hunt for a podium position at the moment. And Lady's checked out, hasn't he? 5.5 seconds in front, Matt.
Yeah, he's gone, Lady, as in this one. He knows he's got to get that foot down and get that race win and hope that John Boy finishes a bit further down the order. John Boy here, though, we've seen him twice now drop behind Fury, as well as picking up a time penalty at the end of this race. Obviously, we said earlier, Kelly, about you've got that winning mentality. Every driver has it. But if you're just making a couple of mistakes here and you're John Boy, do you just sort of get into a... sit behind Fury for a few laps, get into a rhythm, get into a flow, then maybe look to attack him?
I think for me, I would be... just thinking of the championship now. As I said, we're all racers.
Oh, Fury!
Fury went wide and John Boy kind of went all over the place.
It's mistakes here that if he'd have just had a bit more of a twitch on that car, could have lost it. And this is
absolutely
where John Boy's really got to be, like you've just said, championship thinking here in terms of taking it, bringing it home.
Yes, and that is where I think my head would be now. I think I'd want to clear Fury if I could and get my head down. You know, if a silly mistake creeps in and he starts going backwards, it could be championship over, you know. So I think if it was me, I'd be thinking of the long game now. But hey, I'm not John Boy and I'm not in the car fighting for the championship.
Wide through Paddock Hill, Ben. Looked like he had a bit of a slide coming through Paddock Hill as well. As you can see, that gravel trap on the outside sort of getting closer towards you. And John Boy here... similar pace to Fury last lap. The only two was Fury and John Boy in the 129s, quicker than Laney last time out as well. But is he just pushing a bit too hard here? Just trying to gap Delore behind. Don't forget, Delore's no longer in this championship fight. Is he just trying to push too hard here and just maybe gap them a bit too much and try too hard to get past Fiori. It's Gary's got past Pokeney then. And Dan, just coming through Surtees. Dan having a big spin. X-Mart will get past, as will Lodder, Nick Lavilla. And a bit of a reset button there for Daniel.
Yeah. He stayed out of the way for the passing cars, which was something. Delore really beginning to drag back onto the back of this battle. Delore is out of this championship now. There is another argument here that maybe John Boy and Laney just aren't watching the championship. Are just driving race for race, which is possible. Some guys don't even follow where they are in the championship. So. It is possible that they might be just racing every race to the maximum, really.
Yeah, I know myself. I know I'm a kind of guy that I keep my eyes very firmly on it and know what I have to do before going into that night sort of thing. I like to plan out what I've got to do to win a championship or put as much pressure on a championship as possible. So that's what I personally do. But like you say, John Boy and Laney may be a bit different, and John Boy looking around the outside of Fiori at Druids, and if he can keep it round there, he'll have that inside line for Graham Hill Bend, and he has done brilliantly around the outside of Druids, up the inside at Graham Hill. Fiori not too far wide, where it's going to give him a slowdown. Great respect from John Boy there, knowing that Fiori's on his outside, but a bit of a wiggle again on his way down towards Surtees, and Delore's in this battle. Fiori cuts into the middle of them then, and this so far brilliant.
Yeah, and BMW not far behind either. Gary's in this mix as well. He's only a half a second or whatever off the back of this one. And Fiori hasn't given up this second place at all, has he? As John Boy goes back into second place, Fiori goes a little bit wide. Delore gives him space, but he's managed to get up the inside as they come round these tricky little dip through here, and then up the other side. Not as tricky as Paddock Hill Bend, which is the first one. It's probably one of the hardest corners anywhere in the world, I reckon. John Boy now trying to gap Delore, who's got in front of Fiori. Gary now on the back of Fiori as well. And coming into contention with this one is Pinkney as well.
Gary here still showing great pace on a BMW that's not had the best of pace on the dry tracks all season. Gary really is getting the best out of that BMW. And we spoke before he disconnected in the practice session. Five out of the last six races have been on the podiums. So that's 5 out of 7 races on the podium. He might want to make that 6 out of 8 going into his last 8 races on that podium spot. So Gary really pushing. He's been a different... It's as if that BMW, this back half of the season, has been a different car.
Yeah, and I wonder if Dan and Gary have got on top of the setups a little bit, maybe. Mm. And I'm pretty sure that Dan is dropping the BMW. That's what he said in the commentary in Tier 2. That he's dropping the BMW in favour of the Astra for next year. So I think that's brave. Certainly when he's had a season of learning the BMW, I think I'd be sticking with it myself. But again, each their own,
Look at this, Fiori and Delore here, side by side as they come in towards Hawthorns. And Gary kind of going left, going right. He's trying to find a gap to get through. Can't get it done. In towards Westfield now. And then they've got to come through Dingledale just there. It's like a double right-hander back up the hill towards Sheen Curve. And Gary all over the back of Delore here with Fiori just up front in P3. Gary's having a look towards Stirling's end, tucks back in, thinks better of it. Look at the McGann just getting that rear end sliding out a bit. Gary using the curve on exit down the straight now towards Clearways they go to start lap 10 of this race, we're on lap 9 and John Boy's pulling the trigger on the first pit stop. John Boy pulls the trigger then. How good's this stop, Kelly? This is the question. In.
And it ain't a Red Bull one, that's for sure. But not too bad on the scale of things on Project Cars anyway. He's done his pit stop. Everyone has to take one mandatory pit stop. No change of tyres, no change of fuel. Put fuel in unless they want to, of course. But everyone has to take one. And the pit window, the pit lane opened on lap 8. I believe John Boy was the first person to pit.
First person to pit in the pit window. Emo guy obviously pitted end of lap 1. We believe that may have been for a change of tyres because we think he may have been on the wet tyre from qualifying and hadn't changed him into the second race. But yeah, John Boy, first person to pit at the end of that. Where's he come out? P10, and that is Delore, who's had a huge spin coming out of Hawthorns And that's promoted Gary up to P3. Fury now, pressure off of him. Can he keep that pace up ahead of Gary? Was 6 tenths quicker last time around. But with Delore having that bit of an off now, that will help John Boy when Delore has to pit, in terms of he knows no matter how hard Delore pushes, he's had a big, big off. And John Boy will get that one done in the pits.
Absolutely, and I just had a quick glance over the comments, and there's a lot of chat going on in the comments, and I'm trying to look at two things at once, so I haven't had opportunity to read them, but please keep your comments coming. We love to hear them, and we'll get through some in a bit. It's just tense right now, isn't it, Matt?
It's very tense, it's on edge. Delore also deciding to pull the trigger after his spin.
Yes, indeed. So he's in the pits, as you can see, as is Fury. Fury's out of the pits by the looks of it.
Where's John Boy? Where's John Boy?
Where is John Boy? He's coming round now to the start-finish straight. And Fury is now just out of pit lane. I think... Oh, no, I don't want that one. John Boy. And I think... he's just managed to stay ahead of John Boy is Fury. So, nip and tuck with those two. Didn't really... That's where they were.
The undercut didn't seem to work for John Boy, did it? He's had a go. Fury a bit wide at the exit to Druids. And John Boy's going to have a look. But Fury will keep that line and keep that position into Graham Hill Bend then. So the undercut didn't work for John Boy. But obviously he doesn't need to be in front of Fury. He just wants to be.
No. Just wants to, yes. Yeah, brilliant way of putting it. Yes, he doesn't need to. Because he's in net third place at the moment. And that's all he needs to do. Or plenty more than he needs to wrap up this championship this evening. Yes, good pit stop for both of them, even Stevens for those two as they came out. It's all done for them. Six all still got to pit, so yep. I understand if I've done my
yep.
That's right. Right, so 11 laps in at the moment as we stand. John Boy would be the champion as we're going on here. Excuse me, I've got the hiccups. I thought I should point that out, because that's kind of standard on Motive, isn't it? When you hiccup, you go, that was a hiccup.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how it works. Yeah. Yeah. So excuse my hiccups. Still plenty of what is going on in the chat. There is so much chat going on, which is great. This is exactly what we want. Keep the comments coming. As John Boy gets in very deep, Paddock Hill Bend, as I say, one of the trickiest corners anywhere, in my opinion. Unsighted as you come over the top, and the easy to run wide and in the gravel. Once you get in that gravel, there's been some horrendous spins and crashes just in that little dip over the years. But that's the challenge, isn't it? That's what a racetrack's all about.
Yeah, the Brands Hatch GP brings up so many challenges. You know, the GP circuit, it adds an extra element to this Brands Hatch layout that you don't see a lot often.
No, and for many years they didn't use this GP loop at all, did they? And I remember lots of... I remember the first racing game when I can't remember what it was. Always Fury's gone really, really wide, which has given John Boy an opportunity to come up beside him. Fury lets him through. He had no choice, really. He was up the inside. So John Boy moves back up into seventh, which probably nets second after all the pit stops are done and dusted. Pootney goes into the pits as well. And who's that in the background? That's Delore going deep, I think. As I was saying, I can't remember what game it was, but the first time, might have been one of the Tocker games, but the first time that the GP loop ever came up on a game, I couldn't get enough of it.
Yeah.
Couldn't get enough of it. It was just like a mythical thing, the GP loop, for ages, you know? I don't even think at that time that touring cars used it even then, you know? But it was a bit of a mythical beast for quite a while, as John Boy goes deep into that corner, and Fury's now got a run down Paddock Hill Bend and into this braking zone, which is a good opportunity, overtaking opportunity. Fury's got the inside line. John Boy goes all the way around the outside, got the inside line as they drop down and keeps that position. But good racing between these two.
Now, Gary's not pitted here, but he's lost a couple of positions.
What's happened to Gary then? Is he...
I've not seen him in the pits here.
No, I can't say that I have. I was going to say, is there any more damage on his car? But my God, you couldn't really tell, could you? You know? So, has Gary had an off? Maybe, maybe not. We don't know. Still the tightest race on the track at the moment is Fury and John Boy. as they continue to trade places as Fury goes past again. John Boy cuts to the inside. And is he going to make it stick for the next one?
Yeah, I've
looks
just gone
like
back
he's
on
gone.
The, I've just gone back on the stream, Kelly. I think Gary's had enough because Pope Neep's pitted. Gary hasn't pitted, but he has lost out on them three places. So Gary making a mistake somewhere that we haven't seen on screen. But yeah.
Yeah, so as I said, Gary now goes
he's
into
now
the,
in
pits,
the pits,
funnily enough. Yeah. And yeah, look at the state of that BMW. You can see the engine and everything. Yeah. Look. Yeah.
Fancy
yeah,
that.
They fix the front bumper because that's kind of what project car. Oh, no, they haven't fixed it. They've probably just put a new set of headlights in it. And for no particular reason other than they can. Oh, the engine looks lonely. It's what the engine looks like in there. Doesn't look like a lot going on in that engine bay. That's not the normal when you lift the bonnet of a BMW. That's not normally what you see. But then a touring car is a very different thing, to be fair.
It is. Look at where Gary's come out because of that pit stop, because that spin as well. P10. Yeah. Wow. He's lost a lot of time. Was running well in P2 as well, but yeah, he's lost a lot of time. So Laney Lodder, X Mark, Nick the Villa, the only guys not to have pitted. Fourth place up, not to have pitted yet. Then Kelly. And these boys are. They're about 15 seconds off the back of X Mark, Nick the Villa at the minute.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, Nick Villa just having a bit of run wide a little bit as we jumped onto him. He's got X-Mark in front of him. Let's talk about X-Mark for a couple of minutes. The reigning touring car champion for the next 12 laps. Mm. And he didn't have such a great season. Had a brilliant season last season of consistency, did Mark. Did exactly what he needed to do. Enough to put a championship together and... I remember the last race of the season. There was another kind of nail biter and went on to be champion of that one. So as we can see, lovely guy, heart of gold, one of the nicest guy you want to meet.
Yeah.
Although did roll me over on the 24.
Did he roll you over or did you already lose the car?
Well, different views, different opinions. I may have been slightly sideways at the time where he ran into the side of me and rolled me over about six times, but I may have been 90 degrees to the track, maybe, and he may have had nowhere to go, but he had no lights. So what
this
crazy guy is out there with no lights on?
What
you
a
know?
Crazy guy. Who's going?
Crazy guy.
Was going a bit slow there, was X-Mart then, as he's dropped behind Lodder. Poke Neep, P7, ahead of Lee and Delore.
All Team Camber in a row here. Yeah. Look, it's Team Camber, Delore, Team Camber, Vigler, who's Delore's brother, and Pokeney, who's also part of this Team Camber. All these guys from Belgium, aren't they? That's the one. All from Belgium, all friends. And Kurt V.
Pokeney,
what have you done?
Wheel over the curb on the grass, unsettled the car, and round he goes. Just as there was flying formation for Team Camber.
Absolutely. What other teams have we got involved in? Well, there's Team Prolapse. We've got Dan, his Team Prolapse, and Laney and X-Mart.
Team Prolapse. Or Team No-Lapse, as Gary likes to call them.
Absolutely. Taste the Rainbow and all the rest of it. I'm not going to diss my teammates too much because I'm in that stable. So, upcoming new season. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And... in the not the pro lassie team either, not in with the girls.
No, you're in with the real men. You're in with the big boys. As X-Mart is in the pits, leaving the pits now. Is X-Mart there? He is, and he will come out just behind Pokeney.
Yes, indeed. And Pokeney would have been an awful lot further up the road if he didn't have that little spin. But there we go. Who else? An emo guy is your man at the back at the moment. We haven't spoke much about him. Most probably on the wrong tyres is why we see emo guy at the back, because he's usually quite a good peddler, isn't he?
Yeah.
And usually has some good results. Just look at the penalties, Laney.
Wow,
1 second.
Oh, 28 seconds.
28 seconds. Where did you see that?
P12, the Greek. 28 seconds worth of penalties.
I can't see P12. There we go. 28 seconds worth of penalties.
In fact, Vlee and P7's got 14 as well.
14,
so.
Yeah, absolutely. Ooh. Yeah, absolutely. So let's take that off.
Just want to say a very good evening to Nikki. Hey, Matt and Kelly, he says in the chat, the wall. Just want to say a big shout out to Kelly and Matt. Great commentary in the touring cars the whole season. Loved Loved every race to watch. It's so enjoyable, even if I don't like Project Cars 2 to drive.
Fair enough.
Thank you for your fair work. Thank you for your kind words. The Wall. Got time for the Wall. Legend
we
is
have.
The Wall. What a legend.
Have. Yeah, he put some money into our 24 that we did for cancer research, and put the right amount of money in at exactly the right time. But everybody's donations were gratefully received, and £1,300+. Well done, everyone. Well done.
Yeah, brilliant.
Fine moment. But fine moment.
Mega effort. And a big shout out to Gary for that one as well, because it gave me and you the challenge of staying awake for the whole 24 hour on commentary as well as you, while you was driving, and says I'll give an extra, he donated £40 anyway, he says I'll give you an extra £40 if you do it, and stuck to his word. So thank you very much, Gary. Is Lee into the pitch. John Boy now up to P3 with Lodder and Laney, excuse me, the only two cars yet to come into the pit lane. So John Boy at the minute driving the drive he needs to win this title.
Yep, it's looking all good for John Boy right at the moment, isn't he? He's managed to get past that Fury battle he was having and managed to gap Fury by about 4 seconds now.
Yeah.
So he can just roll this one to the end, can't he? Roll it to the end and be champion.
Yeah, he's cruising at the minute. He's got no need to push as Lodder's in the pit, so John Boy should get past Lodder, you'd imagine, just looking at the white dot on the track map going down the pit lane now. There is John Boy coming through clearways. Now then, Lodder's only just pulling into his pit box, so yeah, John Boy's going to easily have Lodder come the end of this one. There you see Lodder still stationary, he's away now, but John Boy's already passed. It's not going to matter to him. Laney still has to make his stop. Where does Lodder come out? Don't forget, Lodder, what
through.
A comeback drive for Lodder. Got taken out on lap one at the start with Dan and Gary, sandwiched in the middle of a BMW either side of him, and he's P4 just ahead of Delore. So heck of a comeback drive by Lodder there to get into the position he's in at the moment.
Yes, hats off to him. Great comeback drive. A real beauty. And net fourth. He's not net first. He's done all his all the pits are done around him, so he is on track, fourth place. Excellent recovery drive from Lodder there, considering he was interfered with by two fast starting BMWs.
Exactly. So by side with Delore as they come down towards Hawthorns at the moment then, and Delore gets up the inside of Lodder and takes that position away from him. So P5 for Lodder at this moment in time.
Delore with a bit between his teeth. He wants that last podium. He's going to end up, I haven't got the championship standings in front of me, but he's probably going to end up third. He was in the hunt for this one at the beginning of this meeting, but a poor first race. He was mathematically possible, but he would have had to have had some really good luck to win and the other two guys out, which didn't happen. We did lose Laney from the sprint race, which has put him on the back foot points wise. John Boy is second place at the moment. All he has to do is roll home and he will comfortably be the champion. That disconnection from Laney was the turning point, wasn't it? That's when really the championship swung to John Boy's way. And it's not over yet. We've still got 7 laps to go of this race and this season, so it could all change. It's looking comfortable for John Boy right now, isn't it?
It's looking very comfortable for John Boy. Laney obviously to pit, but I can't see his pit stop being any longer than anywhere near 35 seconds, to be fair. He's drove what he's needed to do as Laney, but John Boy has done what he's needed to do. He's just kept it on the road, kept it facing the right way. It was a bit scary at the start of this race. Obviously, a few incidents, was dropping back behind Fury, got a time penalty added to his time, and just was sliding around the track a little bit. And we thought, is he going to get to the end of this one? What's going to happen? But he's got into a rhythm, got into a flow, and has kept going.
Yes, indeed. And, run a solid race. That's all he needed to do. Who else can we talk about? Gary, after his couple of incidents, Gary's still without a penalty, but the BMW looking very second-hand. And struggling now in ninth place. Even worse for Dan in the other smashed-to-bits BMW in 11th place. So he's not going all that well. To be fair, he's probably net last, because Emo Guy and the Greek had an extra pit stop as well. So Dan having a terrible run of it. Mm. And that BMW looking very, very second-hand now.
Yeah.
X-Mart, where's X-Mart? He's eighth at the moment, the reigning touring car champion. And having a solid drive. No doubt he'll be back next year for another go at these touring cars. Of course, Renault McGann will be gone for next season, and Astra, Mercedes or BMW will be the choices.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting one next season, isn't it? With no Renault McGanns on the track, it's going to be one that we'll have to keep our eyes on next season. I mean, what we're saying, do you think the BMW is the favourite for that one, or what do you reckon?
I think it's hard to say. I think probably from what I've seen, I reckon the Merc is possibly the strongest car. I believe it has the similar kind of handling and characteristics to the McGann, but isn't quite as powerful. Hence why nobody really uses it, because it just hasn't got the pace. But without the McGann out of the way, my money's on the Mercedes being the hot property. I think it's going to be the Mercedes or the BMW. I don't think the Astra is going to be all that. But if you listen to what Dan says, he reckons that it's the most powerful car in the group. And maybe something that setup will improve if you can set it up correctly. But who knows? What do I know? I pinch all my setups from other people. So, you know, maybe not. Worth tuning in for, that's all I can say.
It's going to be worth tuning in for, it really is. As we have lap 21 of 26. Laney still not been in the pits at the moment. 33 seconds is the gap between himself and John Boy, then with Fiori sat in P3. But Delory starting to make a bit of a battle, as we can see here, with Lodder just behind them on Fiori for that final podium spot. And wouldn't it be fitting if Delory was to get on the podium, the top three on the podium for the final race of the season?
Yes, indeed. I think Fury's got different ideas about that, though. He wants that position as they both go past somebody. Oh, they're lapping. Who are they lapping? The Greek, I think they were lapping there as they came through. This is the battle on track at the moment. These three in close company. You've got Lodder, Delore and Fury, all wanting that last podium position in the last race of the season. And only five laps left now. The two championship contenders out front, John Boy doing what he needs to do to be champion. And I say, this is probably the best scrap on the track right at the moment.
It is the best scrap on the track at the moment, and the best scrap for the final podium position of the season.
Yes, indeed. So as we move into lap 22. Oh, Fury's gone.
Oh, no.
Oh, Fury's
gone. What a shame. What a shame. He's really had a good night tonight. He's been on the pace. That's the Greek as well, having a bit of a spin. But just when it's getting to the final moments of this race, has a bit of a moment. And what a shame for Fury, because he's been brilliant tonight. But Delore and Lodder are still fighting hard for this P3. It's Lodder just going over the curb a bit there. It's not over yet for Delore. He's still got the pressure of Lodder behind him.
Yeah, and we've seen Delore make a couple of mistakes already this evening, so it's these two fighting it out for that last podium position, and could be either of these quite easily. Fury now drops, what does he drop, six seven seconds back behind, but then still comfortable to X-Mart, so probably won't lose any more positions, but such a shame for him. As I say, he was driving really well, and you know, probably one of the most improved drivers I've seen this season. I know this, you know, this Motive has many drivers on many different platforms, some that I don't follow, some that you're in yourself, Matt, and different drivers have their different disciplines that they like, but from what I've seen this season, Fury is one of the most improved guys I've seen.
Yeah, I'd possibly have to agree with you on that one. There's a few people on F1 that race on a Friday night here at Motive that have improved through the season. Gary's one that's declined through the season. I thought I'd get that little dig in there.
Well, you know Danny's the new Gary, don't you?
Well, meant to be teammates, you know, meant to be winning this Constructors title, but when you don't finish six races in a row, it's a bit hard to win a title when there's only one on your scoring points, but I'm not going to get into it, Kelly.
Well, no, it doesn't sound like you're bitter about it at all.
No, he's, you know, F1's a different kettle of fish. You get damage in that game, you smash the wall hard in that and lose your front wheel. It's a different story when you're out the race. But, you know, there's a few people on there, you know, that you've seen improve throughout the season. You've seen people like Brown Recluse and GDBO and Penguin Dude especially really start to get better and hone their skills on F1. You know, just Jose and Green Pies there, heads and shoulders above the rest. In that one, I kind of sit third or fourth most races. But, yeah, you see them guys improving. It makes the battle harder and it makes the fight even more enjoyable from a spectator's point of view as Fiori again, just getting a bit wide and onto the grass and into the wall. And you're right with what you say about Fiori. He just seems to get better and better. At times, when one mistake happens, can just show a little inconsistency and just start to go back to it to what he's done before, but only at times.
I think it's very difficult. I mean, I say I've never driven competitively. I've done a couple of motorsport events locally. Auto Solo is what we did, and I won't get into all that right now. But it's very difficult as a driver to keep your cool and keep your patience. So much being a racing car driver is about patience, and I think that's where Fury's Achilles heel is, maybe.
Yeah.
That, yeah, it gets a little bit frustrated. Has one spin, and one spin usually turns into two or three then.
Yeah.
You know, with that frustration to get back on where you were, and, you know, you think to yourself, I can go faster than this, I can do better than this.
Yeah.
And then you end up just pushing a little bit too
hard. You just
seem
to overdrive the car.
Drive the car, totally. And it's, you know...
Race leader in the pits, Kelly.
Yeah, I just seen that. I was just about to comment that. Laney in the pits should be comfortable. Don't see any reason. The project car's mechanics doing their usual bit of standing there looking at the car.
Look at that. He's away, and John Boy's just coming off the GP part now.
Yeah. Yeah, wow. So it's going to be easy to stay in front. Laney's just run away with this one completely. An absolute masterclass. But it isn't going to be enough. As I said, it's a Felipe Massa, this one. However wonderfully you win the race, it isn't going to be enough today. Excuse me, for the championship.
Well, have we got Timo Glock in here?
Yeah, to help him out. Excuse me. Yeah, I don't think it's going to fall Laney's way for a championship, but he's done nothing wrong out in front.
Nah.
He's now 12 seconds ahead of John Boy, who we know is quick. And yeah, I mean, Laney's coming up now to lap Dan, and that's not something that happens very often, Dan getting lapped. So he's drove an absolute masterclass on this one.
He's been brilliant. Still 12 seconds ahead of John Boy as well. Laney is, you know, we kind of got robbed of the championship fight, didn't we, with race one, with obviously the disconnection of Laney. Kind of got robbed of that real championship battle. He's done everything he's needed to in this feature race. John Boy has just done the same as him. He's done what he needs to. We've kind of been robbed of that championship fight that we've had. As Dan's on the grass and has had a huge spin,
and just nudges Laney.
Nearly. That could have been
dear. Oh dear.
They'd have been fire.
Dan nearly took out the race leader. Oh my God, Daniel would have been mortified, absolutely mortified. We had a chat.
No one can talk to Laney, but Daniel nearly took out a fellow runner-up. What are you doing?
And a fellow teammate.
Yes, of course. Team Prolapse. Yes, Dan. Yeah. You're meant to be helping.
What are you doing, Dan? I mean, Dan's having an absolute shocker, isn't he? From really about 50 yards off the line, he's had an absolute shocker. And, I mean, now he's been beaten by Emo Guy as well. So maybe Dan's doing the right thing and weighing that BMW in for this season and getting himself something new. Because, although he's had its moments of brilliance, mostly it's been a pain for him. So... I've said this
last season, Kelly, a lot. The BMW seems to be better when its tyres are up to temperature and the warmer conditions, in the warmer climates. Are we going to see the BMW thrive next year the more we're going into summer? Is Dan dropping the BMW too early? We'll find out next season, won't we?
Yeah, absolutely. And we will see. And it'll be an interesting talking point and we'll have to remember these comments when we get into the season in about, well, the date hasn't been confirmed, but 3 or 4 weeks time, something like that. Of course, many seasons coming to the end here at Motive, but they all start again very, very quickly. But also the new season on Simplay, GT3 Pro and Pro Am. The force to be reckoned with is the Prolapse team, Nikki 77 and KLF 900 coming to Pro Am this Wednesday. Look out for that. But we have a winner here coming across the line. Laney's going to take the win. A brilliant win as well. Absolutely controlled this one. He goes across the line, P1. And what a winner. Round of applause there. Yes, indeed. Done everything he possibly could.
P1 on the track, Kelly. But not P1 in the title.
But not P1 in the title, indeed. As John Boy comes across the line to be the new touring car champion, and congratulations to John Boy, well deserved. He's a quick boy, he's been quick behind the BMWs in the wet, he's been quick all season. Laney's given him a hell of a run for his money, but this is your new touring car champion, ladies and gentlemen, John Boy.
And hats off to John Boy. He's had a cracking season. He's been fantastic. We spoke earlier at the beginning of the night about consistency, and that was the key thing going forward into tonight's thing. John Boy's had quite a few less podiums than Laney, but the big turning point was the disconnection. That was the real turning point. And poor old, and it couldn't happen to anybody other than the championship leader. And when it's not your night, it's not your night. And this is the virtual world. We all have to deal with connection problems at times and wheel problems and things like this. Well, like drivers in the real world have punches or mechanical failures and things. You know,
Dan Camish at this race a couple of years ago, two years ago, lost the championship. What was it? Brake failure or something like that?
The brakes went on him and he lost it coming into Hawthorns on the GP circuit when he looked set to win the title. And, you know, in his, I think it was his second year in the championship, your heart kind of goes out for him. And obviously now he's not racing in it anymore. But, you know, Laney will come back strong from this. He'll come back next year. He's a quick guy, is Laney. He'll come back strong in this one.
Absolutely, you're quite right. So Laney is your race winner. John Boy comes in second but takes the title. Delore, who I believe came third in the title as well. So all your championship contenders in the top three. So a cracking drive from Delore. A good drive from Lodder. I might say Lodder almost for driver of the day, you know, or certainly this driver of this race, because he went from being smashed up by two BMWs to coming off fourth. So that's a good run. Fury, a couple of mistakes towards the end, but a great, great race. X-Mart, going out champion. I'm sure he'll be the first person to virtually shake John Boy's hand and congratulate him. Gary with BMW, a sterling effort to come back to seventh place. Pootney in a strong eighth. Nick Davila in ninth. Viegler in tenth. And we are rounded off by, as I flick down through, Emo Guy, after being on the wrong tyre, so we believe, coming 11th. Daniel having an absolute shocker. Going to take that BMW straight to the scrapyard and weigh it in 12th. And the Greek was your man in 13th. That is your touring car championship. That is the Motive British Touring Car Championship for this season. The championship will be back in approximately about 3 or 4 weeks' time. The Renault Megane is banned, and we have three cars to choose from, the Astra, the Mercedes, and the BMW. It is an all-European season as well, Matt. It is all-European tracks. No British ones, just Europe. So
it's going to be an interesting season. I cannot wait to get the season back going. Sweet and Sticky will be live at every race, hopefully, for that one
as well. Would you like me to run through the European season once more?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. We've got Dan with us on Autodubs. Dan, are you going to scrap that BMW now?
Oh, yeah, it's gone. It's already gone.
It's gone. He's just stepped out of the car and abandoned it in the pit lane. Somebody have that.
Yeah. He's let Andy Neat plough through it. He's let Andy Neat plough through that one.
Yeah. Andy Neat is more than welcome to take it if he likes. But for the European season next season, we will be heading to Red Bull Ring, Austria, Zolder, Belgium, Catalunya National, Spain, Brno, Czech Republic, Algarve, Portugal, Ostrasavin A, Germany, Monza, Italy, and of course, midpoint of the season, the one that everyone's not looking forward to, is Monte Carlo, Monaco.
I tell you what, I'm looking forward to it. Aren't you, Matt?
It's going to be a cracking drive, I tell you what.
Bring
on Monaco. I can't wait to see.
I love Monaco. I love it.
Full damage. Yeah. Full damage, Monaco. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Full damage.
No. That would be like a scrapyard, wouldn't it?
Dad wouldn't make it home in one piece.
The casino square would look like an absolute scrapyard, wouldn't it? With bits
while
of,
we,
bits
while
of
we're speaking
BMW
of Monaco, Mazepin, Monaco, 2 weeks' time. That's going to be fun.
That'll be a talking point, won't it? Absolutely.
Hasse going to have a big belt.
Yeah, absolutely. Good job he's bringing money. Let's not start that conversation again.
Hey.
Absolutely. So, should we wrap it up there, guys?
Yeah.
We got Dan in the chat with us. He's been the man who's been... what term will we give Dan? Race coordinator? Race director? Race promoter?
Race renewal?
Has he been the Bernie Eccleston of the touring car?
He's been the Alan Gow, hasn't he, really? The Alan Gow of the touring cars.
I was trying to think of it. Something Gow. I couldn't remember his first name right then.
Kelly, I've got your back.
So, thanks to Daniel for putting together a great season and doing all the work behind the scenes. Thank you to you, Matt, for joining me.
Pleasure.
In the commentary box every week. And thank you ever so much. Sweet and Sticky, the best commentary team. Best commentary team in any sim race league. And thank you to all the guys at Motive who put this on for us. And once again, congratulations to John Boy, our new champion. And final words from you, Matt.
Thank you for joining me this season, Kelly. Pleasure to be commentating alongside you. Sweet and Sticky in your box, season 8 in the touring cars. Make sure you tune in for that one. Pleasure. Thank you to Dan and all the Motive Racing guys for putting this one on. Just thank you all. Again, John Boy, massive congratulations. Lainey, I'm sure we'll come back strong next year. And let's see the BMWs do with no Renault Meganes around.
Absolutely. Daniel, anything from you?
No, nothing from me other than just a massive thank you to, again, all the drivers, to the commentators, stewards, everyone who puts us on. It's been an awesome season here at Motive, not just on the touring cars, but in every league as well. So thank you to everyone who runs all the leagues. We will be off on a break for the moment. And I'll tell you what, guys, I'm looking for a brand new season, European season, and I cannot wait to get that new car smell.
Absolutely. If you like what you saw this evening, my name's Kelly Davis and I've been here with Matt Duff. And if you haven't enjoyed it, my name is Martin Brundle and he was David Croft. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you ever so much for your company. Everyone, not just the drivers, but everyone who watches in, from me, from Matt and all the team here at Motive. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Thank you and good night.
Take care. Good night.